Hi, I'm Joe Haller from High End Systems. In this video, I'm going to show you the new configurable MIDI map feature that is part of Hog 4 software 3.15. You've been able to incorporate MIDI devices for quite some time, but the MIDI map was fixed. This could make it difficult to work with MIDI devices that also have a fixed map. Software version 3.15 now allows us to take any MIDI or USB MIDI class device and assign its incoming MIDI data to control features of the desk. Now let's dive in and take a look. Here we have a simple show where I've recorded a few cue lists and scenes. We'll use the scenes as starting looks and the lists for making changes on the fly. As we can see, clicking in Hog PC works, but let's add some MIDI hardware to make our lives a bit easier. Here's the MIDI controller we'll be using. As I said earlier, Hog 4 OS will accept any USB MIDI class device or standard MIDI controller. If you're using a standard MIDI device and you're not using a full bore or a full-size Hog 418, you'll need to add our MIDI LTC widget. First thing we need to do, other than plugging in the USB, is to tell the console what MIDI device we would like to use. To do that, we need to go to the network window. Press Setup and Network or long press in any empty space and select Network. In this window, we need to select our console and then Settings. Once in Settings, select the MIDI configuration window and populate Device 1 with your device, and then click OK. With that done, we'll want to test to make sure we're receiving MIDI from the controller. To do that, we will want to launch the MIDI viewer. Press Setup MIDI, and from the pop-up, select MIDI viewer. Now let's mash a bunch of keys and feel that warming sense of joy that comes from when things just work. Now, let's map. Press Setup and MIDI again, but this time select the MIDI Map Editor. In this window, we have a drop-down that will allow us to select a pre-existing map or add new. Let's add a new map. To the right of the drop-down, we have buttons that allow us to rename the map, delete the map, learn, more on this later, and map import and export. Below that line, we have Add and Remove. If we click Add, we can specify what incoming MIDI information we will want to work with. This is a good option if you know the note or controller value you will be receiving. For example, using playback tracks from Ableton or Pro Tools to trigger scenes. Or if you're simply not connected to the MIDI device at the moment. But because we have our controller plugged in and ready to go, we will use the Learn function. Let's turn Learn on. Take a note of the blinking red message in the command line. While in Learn mode, I'm going to press these three buttons on the controller. Notice how the button presses populate in the map. Now let's turn Learn off. I'm going to use the buttons we just learned to playback our scenes. And because we don't have these scenes on playbacks, we'll use comment macros. The furthest right column is where we'll make this magic happen. By double-clicking in the cell, we get a drop-down of all the things we can make this MIDI note trigger. Scroll down to find Go Scene, click on it, and type the number of your scene. For the next two, I'm going to directly type in GS for Go Scene, and then the scene number. Now, let's assign it to our device and press those buttons. Remember that sense of joy from earlier? Nice, isn't it? Now we're going to map our cue lists. Here's a quick tip if you're using a MIDI keyboard as a wing. Map your playbacks to the black keys. These keys are raised up and in a repeating pattern, making it easier to hit the right one without looking. Now let's turn Learn mode back on. Like before, I'll press the key on the controller. But this time, I'll click on the button on the hog that I want to associate it with. Now let's turn Learn off and give it a quick test. Nice. One more thing. Take a look at the first two cue lists. They're labeled Chaser and Bally. These are just effects that I recorded as cues. Another new feature in 3.15 is tap tempo for effects. To set the tempo, you need to hold down the choose while tapping the pause key. Let's map that. Just like before, turn learn mode on. Press the keys you want to map. I'm using the adjacent white keys. Then press the buttons on the hog. Once done, turn learn off. Let's play that chaser list. Hold down the key you map to choose and tap pause. Awesome. That's it. I hope you find this useful, and as always, let us know if you have any questions.